Hello, everyone. I'm Susan Seaforth Hayes. This is
Suzanne Rogers.
The Brass at Days of Our Lives has decided they would like to hear some women's history from the women who've been around the show for a while. So it's going to be your history.
Okay.
And I'm excited because I'm learning things about you all the time, even though I've known you 35, 40?
Is at least.
We're going to start now.
All right.
This lovely tea party. We're not going to be seduced by the pastries.
No, even though they're calling.
Okay. What year did you start on Days of Our Lives?
1973.
Suzanne Rogers' character was called Maggie, and she was a farm girl living in the outskirts of Salem, way in the outskirts. So, your first scene?
Yes.
First day?
Yes.
Who was it with?
John Clark,
yes.
Who played Mickey Horton,
right.
Who didn't know who he was, so he was Marty Hansen.
He'd escaped from the insane asylum. He was having a little episode of amnesia. I had no idea where he was.
Hello? Anybody here?
Yes. Who is it?
And he met this gorgeous, red-headed girl who was ambling about on crutches because she had an undisclosed difficulty walking. She was so good. Suzanne was one of the first new characters to come on the show that was coming from the outside world with a whole different background and this whole aura of innocence and untouchability and beauty, which added a big dimension to the show.
You're gonna make me cry.
No! I remember very well how stunningly beautiful she was, which she never has understood. She thinks it's her hair.
So for 2.5 years, I was on crutches.
Will you take these and put them in the kitchen, please? I don't need and I don't want crutches, not even in the same room.
Thank God.
Gracefully.
I was coordinated.
Extremely coordinated. Now, how did you get so coordinated? You're from Richmond, Virginia.
Richmond, Virginia.
You started dancing, how old were you?
Two.
Two.
My mother's best friend was a dancing teacher.
That's it.
That
they
was
blew
the beginning. Taps on my baby shoes.
When she was a little bit older than two, and this wonderful dance teacher would take her, the best student in her classes, to New York. So when the time came that you wanted to leave Richmond, Virginia, did you want to go?
I wanted to go back to New York to become a Rockette. Everybody wanted to see the Rockettes. Everybody wanted to go to Radio City. It was a movie and a stage show. So I thought, okay, that's what I want to do. They said, don't come if you're not a strong tap dancer, if you don't know how to do jazz or ballet, if you don't have eye-high kicks, that means your kick up to your eye.
Without getting in your eye, mind
yes.
you.
And fan kicks, where your leg goes like this.
How many people were auditioning?
Plus me, 71.
How many people were they going to hire, Suzanne?
Three.
She made it. Okay, you did how many shows a day as a Rockette?
Normally 4 shows a day, 7 days a week.
7 days a week.
But during Christmas and Easter, 5 shows a day. And they paid us 25 cents. So we struck. So we went out and we picketed. We picketed in front of Radio City.
Did you do high kicks in front of Radio City while
but
you were picketing?
We were cute.
That could have worked.
We were very cute.
She moved out of the Rockettes into doing top Broadway shows. I got to see Suzanne in Los Angeles when she was touring with Follies.
Yes.
While she was in Los Angeles, a part came up on Days of Our Lives. And she got the job!
It was like a family. It was a family I never had.
It was a family.
It was a family I never had.
It was a family I never had.
You know?
Suzanne and I have been pretty close through the years. When she got married, I was determined that she was going to have a beautiful shower. And everybody from the studio came to the shower.
I put on my wedding dress because no one was at my wedding.
And we wanted to see it.
And you wanted to see it. So I put on my wedding dress and put my hair up just like I did when I got married. Thank you so much.
We had a good time.
We had a wonderful time.
The marriage might have been not too much fun, but we had a good time at the party.
Forget it.
What are those scenes on the show that are pivotal moments that you'll never forget?
Well, when I walked.
Oh, yeah.
And I was operated on by my husband, Mickey. Yes, the operation was a success. And my husband brought me a box, and I opened up the box.
And in the box was?
And in the box was dancing shoes. And he said, when you walk, you will wear these red shoes.
You were born to dance, Maggie.
I mean,
It was happy for the audience, and extremely happy for the actor.
Oh, my goodness.
Now,
let's
talk about the show where you won the Emmy.
I owe your mother a great deal of thanks for that. Susan's mother, Elizabeth Hauer, she was the one that wrote the pivotal scene that I submitted for my Emmy, and I won. It was a scene where I lost my daughter, and my husband took her down. Oof, took her down to the car.
It's only a show, baby doll.
I know. And I looked out the window, and that was it. I turned around, and the apartment was empty, and I was by myself without my daughter. And I just collapsed to my knees. That was one of the saddest ones. But your mom wrote it for me.
And you got the golden statue.
I got the golden statue. Yes, I owe your mom.
Well, we all owe a lot to our female relatives.
Absolutely.
Looking back.
Oh, my goodness.
Most important lady on the show?
Pat Falkensmith was I love Pat.
Tremendous writer.
Tremendous writer. And, of course, Betty Corday. Frances was, she kind of took me under her wing. She knew I was green. She just told me to be prepared, never to let people wait.
I think we all owe the ladies that came before us in this business.
Yes.
A debt of gratitude.
Absolutely.
That there is a resurgence of interest in the contribution of women who are, shall we say, past 25.
Absolutely.
And are still delivering the goods.
We've had some of the strongest women characters on days of any of the other soaps.
And I like to think we still do.
And we still do.
Well, we still have you.
And we still have you.
And coming up pretty soon, we're going to have another interview where you're going to quiz me.
Absolutely.
I'm looking forward to that.
Oh, my goodness.
Please tune in to Days of Our Lives. It's only been on the air 57 years.
Yes.
It's really a hell of a show. And now I think perhaps we'll get back to our pastries. Salute you, the audience that we love, and salute each other.
Cheers.
The girlfriend of a lifetime.